Yes, yes.
And you may not be able to get to the church house,
uh-huh,
but if God is in your house, then you're in the house of the Lord.
Yes,
here we
go.
Yes, here we go.
I was glad when they said unto me,
I was glad
when they said unto me,
I was glad
when they said unto me,
let us go
into the house of the Lord.
Sing it, honey.
I was glad when they said unto
me, I was ecstatic, overjoyed. Yes,
I was glad when they said unto
me, that he woke me up this morning.
I was glad when they said unto me,
and since I'm breathing,
let us go into the house.
I'm gonna praise the Lord.
Yes, your way. Let's have church.
He's a little too good.
Let's have church.
He's been too kind.
Let's have church.
And he's been a wonderful.
Let's have church.
All time.
Hallelujah.
He put food on my table.
Let's have church.
I know he's able.
Let's have church.
He's got clothes on my back.
Let's have church.
And I won't go back.
Let's have church.
God is good.
Let's have church.
All of the time.
Let's have church.
And all the time, time,
time. Let's have church.
God is good.
Let's have church.
I was glad when they said unto me.
Then he woke me up this morning.
I was glad when they said unto me.
Invited me in his presence.
I was glad when they said unto me,
Let us go
into the house of the Lord.
Let us go
into the house of the Lord. Let us go into the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise God for more blessings flow. Hello, this is Dr. Michael A. Cousin, the pastor of St. Paul AME Church in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, the southern part of heaven, welcoming you to another celebration, a worship celebration here at St. Paul. My brothers and sisters, we are blessed as we are preparing to enjoy the season of Advent, the expectancy of the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. And at this time, we're thankful to have you with us again on this day. We're blessed to have friends who will be celebrating with us in this worship service. And we're mightily blessed that you're able to be with us as well. And now, as we prepare ourselves, let us prepare now as we bow our heads for a word of prayer, as we welcome in the presence of the Lord into this place. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you, Lord, for blessing us and for allowing us to gather once again in your name. Lord, we ask, and we ask that your presence will be with us today and the days to come. Lord, teach us to be grateful and teach us to be thankful for the many gifts that you have bestowed upon us. And now we ask that you will bless our songs, bless our praise. Lord, bless the word that it may go forth and to touch someone's life, that someone may be changed and made the better of it. And Lord, when you bless us, we'll be quick and always careful to give you the honor, the glory, and the praise which is due to you. For it's in the matchless name of Jesus the Christ, our Lord and Savior, which we pray. Amen. Amen. And as we celebrate this first day of Advent, our theme today is hope. Enjoy this Advent reading from one of our families in the church, Brother Deese and Sister Carol Deese.
This place is a mess. Week 1, November 29th, 2020. The scriptures are taken from Isaiah 64 chapter, 1st through the 9th verse, and Mark 13, chapter 24 through 37.
If ever there was a year we needed Advent, this is the year. We hardly know how to describe the year we have lived through. We hesitate to reflect on all of the mess around us in 2020. All we know is that nothing seems right. Nothing seems like it used to be. Nothing. We need Advent.
The prophet Isaiah cried out for us, "Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down to make your name known, so that the nations might tremble at your presence. So tear through the mess, O Lord, and come down to us again. We long to be your people, a people of hope."
We light this first candle as a sign of our hope. Hope that you can meet us, even in the mess of our world. Hope that you still see us. Though we feel we are lost in the rubble, let this light be the guide that brings us to Emmanuel once more.
O come, Emmanuel.
You. not create me to worry. You did not create me to fear. But you created me to worship him. So I'ma leave it all right here.
Everyone, I'm Shantae and I'm here to provide you with your lectionary text for November the 29th, 2020. It is taken from the 80th Psalm and today we'll look at lines 1 through 7 and 17 through 19. I'll use the New Revised Standard Version for our reading today. And it reads, "Give ear, O Shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph like a flock. You who are enthroned upon the cherubim, shine forth before Ephraim and Benjamin and Manasseh. Stir up your might and come to save us. Restore us, O God. Let your face shine that we may be saved. O Lord God of hosts, how long will you be angry with your people's prayers? You have fed them with bread of tears and given them tears to drink in full measure. You make us the scorn of our neighbors. Our enemies laugh among themselves. Restore us, O God of hosts. Let your face shine that we may be saved." And line 17, "But let your hand be upon the one at your right hand and the one whom you made strong for yourself. Then we will never turn back from you. Give us life and we will call on your name. Restore us, O Lord God of hosts. Let your face shine that we may be saved." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be unto God. From all that dwells below the skies, let the Creator's praises arise. Let the Redeemer's name be sung by every land and every tongue. Hear what Christ our Savior saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise God. These are the announcements for St. Paul for this week. On December 5th, beginning at 11 o'clock, we again will be passing out our communion elements for members to celebrate and prepare for First Sunday, which will be December 6th. We invite you to come out on that day at 11 o'clock for your communion elements. Also, we'll be passing out our church school literature for this quarter. Please come by, get your information, get your material, so you may follow along with our Wednesday night church school taught by Sister Shantae Smith, as well as on Sundays at noon, our youth church school, which is held and conducted by Sister Deese and Sister Evelyn Ponder and Reverend Mary J. Palmer. We invite you. There's so much happening here at the church, and we welcome you to be a part. And if you're looking for a church home or a place to just work out, amen, your salvation, here it is at St. Paul. We welcome you. St. Paul, be blessed to have you as a member, and I'll be blessed to be your pastor. And now, enjoy this next slide as you can see and learn how you may contribute to the ministries here at St. Paul AME Church.
It's giving time, and we thank you for supporting the church at such a time as this. There are different ways in which you can send a gift to the church for the support of the ministry. First, you can give through Givelify.com, our online giving app. Just go to Givelify, type in the name of the church, St. Paul AME Church. There you will see a picture of the church and a picture of the pastor. Select the amount in which you wish to give, click, and that's it. Or you can send your gift through the U.S. mail at St. Paul AME Church, 101 North Merritt Mill Road, Chapel Hill, North Carolina, 27516. Or if you're in the neighborhood, just feel free to drop by and drop off your gift. We'd love to sit in fellowship with you and just talk about the goodness of the Lord. And remember, my brothers and sisters, we thank you for your support. And as always, I'll pray for you, you pray for me, and watch God change things.
Thank you. Let us look to the Lord in prayer. And now may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please turn your Bibles to the New Testament book of 1 Thessalonians. 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, beginning at the 16th verse. Reading from the New Revised Standard Version, we find the passage recorded thusly. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit. Allow me to read that one more time. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit. For just a moment, I want to share with you and preach upon these words, gifts worth giving. Gifts worth giving. As we prepare for this season of Advent, the great anticipation, the arrival of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the hope that we lift up today, we as Christian believers, we should be viewed differently due to the qualities or the traits that are blessed upon us through our relationship with God. You know, people should be able to tell you are a Christian, not so much by the outside, but what you do on the inside, which affects how you live on the outside. We should not be known for just believing, but we should be known for behaving. Our behavior is reflection upon in whom we put our trust. We should behave in such a way that people know that we know the Lord for ourselves. And you know, from this relationship, there are some gifts endowed upon us that we should be willing to share with the world in this season of giving now. We should be willing to give some gifts worth sharing. This is an interesting letter Paul writes to a church. It's a smaller congregation, but he loved this church, for they wanted to know more about their relationship with God and in terms of resurrection, what happens, you know, in terms of the afterlife. And Paul tells them that we should have that relationship with God, which gives us the assurance that once we put it in God's hands, everything is all right. And it's how we live those gifts that God gives to us that help us make it through this world in which we call life. There are some qualities worth sharing that we can bless the world with as Christians, some gifts that we can give to the world to make this world a better place. There's some things that we can do that are on the inside that reflect on how we live on the outside. In this passage, it preaches itself. And there are a couple of things I want to lift up right now. The first gift is we can teach folk how to be joyful. Yeah, joyful. When you walk into the company of others, things should get better. When you go to church, things should get better. Why? Because you're there. And you are the one to make things better. Should be a better conversation in your life, what you talk about. You know, you talk about things, first of all, you know about, and talk about those things that are beneficial to others. And when you have better conversation, it's a reflection of better behavior. You know, you're learning to grow in Christ. You know, what I do now at this stage of my life, you know, is different from what I used to do years ago. Because you should become better, wiser. You should be blessed with all the things that God has given unto you because of your conversation, better behavior. You're in better company. You know, it's something when you're around positive folk that are believing and tell you everything's going to be all right. I don't need to be in a pity party, be in a place around negative folk. No, negative folk can bring you down. But when you are gifted with positive blessings, with blessings in your life, you want better conversation, leads to better behavior. Joyful is not being on a supernatural high all the time. It's just learning to be content and not overdo it. You know, sometimes we overdo it. I like to go work out, but I can't go every day. I would like to go every day, but there are times you can burn yourself out trying to overdo things that you think you're helping, but you're really overdoing it. And I find myself feeling some aches and pains in places I thought that I did not know existed. So I have to pull back a little bit. Don't overdo it. And that's what it is with joy. You know, you're content, but don't overdo it. There's an inner peace. That's what joy is, an inner peace which calms you and controls you. And it gives you that assurance that comes from on high. Joy. Joy. Joy is not such a temporary thing. It is a continuous calmness in your life. I have joy deep down in my soul. Teach people how to be joyful. You teach them, share that gift, teach them how to read the word of God for themselves. That's where joy comes from, when you read the word of God and reminds you that upon the promises of God. But the biggest thing is when you read the word of God for yourself, joy comes because it reminds you that there are more promises than problems. There are more promises than problems. That's something to shout about right there, St. Paul, that you know that when you read it for yourself, the possibilities, give the gift of joy, being joyful, joyful. Secondly, teach folk how to be prayerful. Give them the gift of prayer. Teach them how to be prayerful. You know, keep a prayerful attitude. Be ready to pray at all times. The best prayers are short prayers. You don't have to be something that's written out of script. Just pray from your heart. The best prayer I've noticed that I've learned for myself says, "Thank you, Lord." Or, "Lord, just help me. Be with me today." You know, be ready and be quick to pray. Pray. Be prayerful. And not only just those quick prayers, but teach other folk how to pray. Teach them about the various prayers, the prayer of petition. "Lord, I need your presence." How to bring God into your life. "Lord, I want you into my life." A prayer petition. "Lord, what is it that's upon my heart? There's a need there. Lord, I need you first and foremost." That's followed by the prayer of praise. "I thank you for all you've done in this season. I thank you, Lord, for delivering me. But more importantly, I thank you for your presence. When I asked, you were there. I thank you." Teach people how to be prayerful. Joyful. Prayerful. What other gift you got, Reverend Cousin? Well, let me tell you. Teach folk how to be thankful. You know, God has blessed you with all these years, and you can't say thank you. You know, God has blessed you with so much, and you can't say thank you, Lord, for all you've done in this season that we have lived in 2020. Praise God. God has brought us through and sustained us. If there's any other thing we should be thankful for, be thankful that he walks with us each and every day in all things, in all circumstances, in all situations. Learn to give thanks. Be thankful for all that he gives you. Be grateful. And I thank God in all circumstances through prayer. He has blessed me to know that he has not brought me this far to leave me. In all things, give thanks for faith. That relationship with God is more than just believing, but having a relationship with him, with God, that lets me know that all things are possible. And learn to be prayerful. You know, it's something I've learned in ministry. You want to know who's really in tune, has a good relationship with God, ask somebody to pray on the spur of the moment. I recall asking a brother to pray, and the brother almost fainted. He was so scared. He didn't know what to say. And finally, I just had to tap him. That's all right, brother. I can pray. And I went on and led the group in prayer. When you're a child of God, or you're in a relationship with God, you're quick to pray because you know how to pray each and every day. There's power in prayer. It's not just how long you pray. It's just being prepared to pray each and every opportunity. Learn to be prayerful. Lord have mercy. God is good in all circumstances. Be thankful, prayerful. Just learn to say thank you. Just thank you. Those two, prayerful and thankfulness, run together. Be thankful. And as we come to the close of this message, the greatest gift you can give right now is not just being joyful and prayerful and thankful. You better be careful. Teach people to be careful. Careful not to restrain the work of the Holy Spirit. You know, that's a common thing when we try to quench the Spirit, when we want to slow down the work of the Lord. Careful, be careful to stay away from certain situations. There are things that you don't need to be involved in. Careful for those situations. Be careful to stay away from certain people. Certain people you know mean you no good. Pray God that you bring people into my life that'll add something to my life. Be careful of the things you get involved with. Oh, make sure that those are things of God. You know, what a church this would be if we're just careful to give God God's due. Careful to always praise God. Prayerful to realize where our blessings come from. Prayerful in whom we put our trust. Prayerful and careful of what God is doing in our lives. Be careful, my brothers and sisters, not to quench the Spirit. Oh, what a church this would be if we were just careful about these things. I was reading about a preacher who went into a bookstore. And the pastor was looking for a book to help the pastor understand Christianity. Going to preach on some points that he tried to understand. They pointed him to the religion section, the section on religion. And as he was scanning the books in the section of religion, the pastor discovered a book entitled The Art of Interior Decorating. Naturally, the pastor realized that that book was in the wrong section, a book on interior decorating in the religion section. As he reached to grab the book, he stopped. He realized, and it dawned upon him, that maybe this book is where it's supposed to be. For after all, what is the Christian faith but interior decorating, where we are changed on the inside? What you possess on the inside should be shared on the outside. And when you've been changed on the inside, you not only show your gifts, but you've learned how to share these gifts. That's what the hymn writer tells us when we share the greatest gift. Share the gift of Jesus. More about Jesus would I know. More of his grace to others show. More of his saving fullness see. More of his love who died for me. More about Jesus. More about Jesus. More of his saving fullness see. More of his love who died for me. The greatest gift we can give right now is give the gift of Jesus. And on this day of hope, learn to give some good gifts. Oh, joyfulness and prayerfulness and thankfulness and being careful for what all that God has blessed you to receive and being able to give God the glory. My brothers and sisters, maybe this is a time that somewhere within the sound of my voice, you don't have a church home. The greatest gift you can give right now is make sure you're in relationship with God. Oh, never take it for granted. Never take those gifts for granted that God is blessing upon us and willing to give us more when you are grateful. You know, last week, the local bakery gave us some baked goods. Two bags of baked goods. And I went by and thanked them. I said, thank you so much for this. We shared it with folk. And oh, just on this day when I put up to the church, instead of two bags, there were five bags of all kinds of baked goods. And I said, I don't know how I'm going to share all this stuff. And I'm blessed right now. That's how God works. When you give thanks, God gives more to you. When you have that relationship, God is willing to bless you. God is ready to bless you. God wants to bless you. But are you ready to receive it? That's when you get right now. Don't let this year go out and you still don't have a church home. You still never renewed your covenant. Maybe you've never made a covenant. Right now is your opportunity. If you're looking for a church home, just get in touch with us. Or better yet, you find a church that's close to you where you can fellowship and be a part. We are blessed to have you here with us at St. Paul. And we pray that you will come to the realization that you need a church home. The greatest gift you can have right now is a relationship with Almighty God. And right now, let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you for this opportunity. We ask right now that you would touch that person's heart that needs to be in relationship with you, that wants to be in relationship with you. Remove fear, remove doubt right now. Replace it with your love, your grace, and your mercy. We pray right now, Lord, you will help us in this season as we move closer and closer to the end of this year. You would teach us to share for the many blessings and many gifts you have given to each and every one of us. And Lord, when you bless us, we'll be quick and careful to give you the honor, the glory, and the praise. For it's in the precious name of Jesus the Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. How blessed we are to have been together. Now, I want you to know the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to smile upon you and be gracious unto you. And may the Lord lift up the light of his countenance on you, grant you his peace now and forevermore. Amen. And as always, my brothers and sisters, until we gather again, remember, I pray for you. You pray for me. And watch God change things. Be blessed.
This is